Welcome back. As we promised in our intro, we are going to take a quick look at Egypt's future mega project or مستقبل مصر. Well, it's a mega project when it comes to agriculture and the expansion of agricultural land is one of the priorities of the state to make sure that food security is implemented on the ground, achieved on the ground. And this is something which was really focused on by the state recently, particularly amid all the economic changes and challenges the whole world is facing, and of course Egypt is no exception. To shed more light on the mega project, we are very much delighted to have with us via phone Dr. Abulhuda Serafi, advisor for exploration. Thank you very much for being with us, sir, and a very good morning to you.
Good morning. Firstly, I'd like to thank you very much for your kind invitation to join this interview.
Thank you very much, sir, and we are very much delighted to have you. Before going into details, if you want to give us such a brief idea about مستقبل مصر project or Egypt's future project in the west of Egypt.
Yes, Egypt's future project for agricultural production is considered as one of the most important national projects for developing Egypt. The main aim of this project is to reclaim about 4 million hectares. The land project is mainly distributed along maybe four districts. Firstly, in the south of Egypt, southwest of Egypt, the access between this district between Tushka and east of Ainat. This is about 500,000 hectares. Secondly, the Dakhla and Farafra district, about another 500,000 hectares. And the third, the axis extend from north to south, from Asyut, Armenia, Beni Suif, and Fayoum government.
Yeah.
Okay. And the most
Dr. Serafi, if you permit me, I'd like to focus more on the important crops which are now cultivated in this area. Because when it comes to Egypt's weather, I think it's one of the merits we have, of the God blessings we have. What are the most important strategic crops which we are going to harvest today after 2 years since President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi launched Egypt's future mega project?
Yes, President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi gave the start of this project in 2022. And the most important phase of this project is what's called the New Delta project. That the land or the end area of this project is about 2.2 million hectares, which represents about 23% of the already cultivated land in Egypt. It depends on three sources of water. Firstly, the underground water. Secondly, the agricultural waste water recycled at Hammam station, which is considered as one of the most important and the biggest capacity for water recycling.
Yeah.
In this project, so in this area, we did need to use the desalinated water from the
stations we built in specific for this reason. And to add to what you have just said, sir, and would you please correct me if I'm wrong, this is to continue with the Egyptian strategy to maintain food security, self-sufficiency from those agriculture or food products, and also to increase our exports and to invade new markets with our products, true?
Yes, this project is mainly aimed to bridging the gap between the consumption and the production, the real production. This will, in this project, strategic, we already choose strategic crops to be to be produced, and this will contribute efficiently in saving the hard currency and to limit the amount of importing crops from outside.
Yeah. Sir, also, these mega projects are playing such a vital role to fight unemployment. And it was said more than once by our top executives that the country or the state is looking forward to implement on the ground more mega projects which are providing thousands, or to be accurate, hundreds of thousands of direct and indirect job opportunities. If you want to elaborate on that too.
Yes, one of the most important outcome of this project is to provide job opportunities to thousands of engineers and technical people. This will provide a very important chance to limit the problem of unemployment in Egypt.
Yeah, and to add to this also, agro-industry projects, or the projects which depend on both fields, whether it's agriculture and industry, they are going to be also one of the priorities we have of the one of our strategic directions, if I may call it this way, to have this complementary issue, to have this panoramic view. If you want to also speak about this issue and how this is going to be implemented on the ground, or already implemented on the ground, to push forward our economic process and to achieve our sustainable development goals.
Yes, this project is a dual purpose project. It is not only a project for agriculture, but also depends on the industrial issues. So will the produced crops will be processed and in some industries very close to the cultivated land. This will also help in supporting the capacity of Egypt for exporting crops outside.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and of course this is one of the merits of the location of this mega project to be on the west of Egypt. It's very close to many of our ports, so it's going to be much easier for us to continue with our exports process, if you want to also elaborate on that.
Yes, this project, mega project, is mainly based on a visibility study concerning the quality of the land, I mean the soil condition, and the studying of the capacity of the underground water reservoirs and the capacity of recycling water from the agricultural hectares in the delta. So, and also it's very important to add that 100,000 greenhouses will be used in this project. The capacity of or the production of each of one of these greenhouses is three times the production of a normal agriculture. So this will this project is mainly based on the very advanced techniques for irrigation.
Then I can just summarize what you have just said, sir, saying clearly that this project is based on scientific studies regarding the type of the soil, regarding the irrigation techniques, and regarding the crops which we expect that they are going to be successfully cultivated in all these thousands of hectares or fedens we have. True?
Yes, this is exactly right.
Yeah.
And this is the first phase. We have a plan for the future to extend this project westward and northward. And by the way, I like to say that during planning for this project, all the infrastructure need to this project is already available. For example, the electricity is very important factor in this project, and also we already used the more developed irrigation systems, and the new and also the new species of seeds for agriculture already produced in our research centers in the Ministry of Agriculture.
Yes, sir. And since you are the a former chairperson of the Nuclear Materials Authority, I'd like to speak a little bit about El Daba nuclear plant, as it's also located there, and how, when we do have this plant activated, it's going to be a source of clean energy, and it's going to help a lot in providing energy to many of our projects there, whether it's Egypt's future mega project or any other projects which are planned to be executed on the ground in the very near future.
Yes, it is a very important task. The Egypt nuclear program is already dual purpose, not only for electricity production, which is very important to providing this mega project, agriculture project, with the energy used, and also for desalination of the Mediterranean sea water. This will provide fresh water for the development of the northern coast of Egypt. Yep. Another factor, the use of nuclear power in this nuclear reactor saves about 14 million tons of pollution when we use the normal fossil energy like oil or natural gas. So this nuclear power plant would save in providing a clean environment for agriculture. Okay, this will provide the new free environment, free of pollution.
Yeah.
This will be providing and using the this is very important for producing more safe crops.
Yeah. Well, Dr. Abul Huda Serafi, advisor for exploration, thank you very much for your input, sir, and have a very good day. Right after the short break, we are going to return back with more, so stay tuned.